Previous lecture. Phineas Gage. Broca's aphasia. Each side of the brain mediate separate mental abilities, kinda different consciousness, and don't have to be aware of one another. Today. Methods of studying the human brain. Lesions. Stimulation. Recording, like fMRI, EEG. One stroke. Where tissue in the brain no longer receives its vascular supply. Stroke, CVA blood flow is disrupted. Hypoxia, lack of oxygen. Tumors, abnormal cell growth. Degenerative disorders, Alzheimer's, Huntington's, Parkinson's, Korsakoff's. Epilepsy, resection. Prosopagnosia, deficit in recognizing faces. Left hemisphere, important for local and functional features. Right hemisphere, for global features and appearances. Hippocampus, knowing things. Basal ganglia, learning how to do things. But there are problems with brain injuries. The damage is hard to localize, it's not systematic. It changes different things, patient by patient. Paul Broca. Patient Mr. 10. He had an injury in the Broca's area, so he could no longer speak. Broca's aphasia by behavior. People who have trouble speaking, but the comprehension is pretty good. The most important part of Broca's area related to the loss of speech is the precentral gyrus of the insula. You have one in each side of the brain, that runs from the temporal lobe, to the frontal cortex. And there's report of people who had stroke in the posterior insula, and instantly gave up smoking, and never wanted to smoke again. Stimulation. 1. Putting electrodes in the brain. 2. Using transcranial magnetic stimulation. It generates a magnetic field that passes through the skull and induces a current, and currents drives a lot of neurons to fire. E.g. If you put it in the motor cortex, people will twitch or say that somebody touched them. Put it in the occipital cortex, visual cortex, and they won't see nothing, you make him cortically blind just for a moment. 3. Record brain structures. Recording structure, anatomy, like angiography, CT. Recording function, physiology, activity during cognitive processes, like EEG, fMRI. Huntington's disease damage the caudate, part of the basal ganglia, it erases it. Without hippocampus you can't learn any new fact, or remember any event in your life. In people with Alzheimer it's almost inexistent. Dementia equals involve memory loss and cognitive impairment. As you age and get new knowledge your cortex gets thinner, because your brain matures in higher thought areas. Visual cortex, vision coming in. Somatomotor cortex, how you feel and movement. Hippocampus. Involved of formation of new memories, learning. Your hippocampus gets thicker when you study like crazy for a test. London taxi cab drivers. They have to take a lot of exams to get their official taxi license. So the London taxi drivers who had the bigger hippocampi, were the ones who drove longer. People who did a routine of juggling for 3 months. Had thicker parts of the brain involved in the visual motion. But they measured their brain 6 months later, and this change was gone. So every activity that you do, is constantly changing your brain, but if you stop doing it, it goes back to basics. Diffusion tensor imaging, DTI. It visualizes white matter, myelinated axons that are superconducting. DTI shows the organization of white matter measuring the movement of water at microstructural level. Because the water tends to go along parallel with the white matter. Dyslexia equals difficulty to read. People who read a lot, have higher white matter around the temporal parietal cortex. Spatial resolution, how precise. Temporal resolution, time scale. Mental operations occur around 10 milliseconds. Egg. They put electrodes in your head. It measures changes in electrical activity, changes of neurons millisecond by millisecond. But only measures overall brain activity. ERP, event-related potentials. It time-locked to stimulus. Magnetoencephalography MEG. Active neurons produce small magnetic fields. Where MEG detect these magnetic changes. Anything that your brain does is millisecond by millisecond interaction between large-scale brain networks. The vasculature that surrounds and supports the neurons are the things that compute the mind. Neurons require oxygen and glucose to do their work. And when the area is active, it increases blood flow and energy supplies. Brain facts. 1.5 kilos. 2% total body mass. 20% of body's oxygen. Loss of oxygen for 10 minutes causes irreversible brain damage, especially in the hippocampus. When you do anything, your blood pressure rise, because it supports the mental operations that you do. Positron emission tomography, PET. Measure local brain activity, looking at the photons disintegrating when you do something. Reading has been around only for about 700 years. Right equals global. Left equals local. Substantia nigra and the basal ganglia, are damaged on patients with Parkinson's. At least 80% of the cells of substantia nigra have to die to see Parkinson's symptoms. People with Parkinson's have very low number of dopamine receptors. Why video games are so successful? Because parts of your brain that are involved in reward, like dopamine receptors, get highly activated. The better you do equals more reward. fMRI. It focuses on hemoglobin, carries oxygen in your blood. It measures the change in blood. The changes in oxygenated to deoxygenated hemoglobins, that change the magnetic field as we measure it. E.g. 1. Empathy. Two people who care about each other. One person will get a shock, and the other will see the other person getting a shock. They wanted to know what difference is between feeling pain, and observing pain in somebody you care about. They found that the anterior cingulate, and in the insula get activated in both cases. Which means that you turn on some of the same brain areas, as when you feel physical pain and seeing somebody else you care about receiving pain. E.g. 2. Ultimatum game, fairness. Two players, proposer and responder. Somebody comes and say it will give you $10, only if the other person agrees on the amount that you give him. If you offer him $5, 50%, most of the times he would agree. But if you offer him $2 or less, you have a 50% chance that he would say no. Then, they do this multiple times with different people. And there's was one guy who always offers you the $2. And other guy offers you $5. Then, you see how both get shocks. Women. For the guy who offered you $5, women feel a lot of empathy. And they still feel a little bit of empathy for the guy who offered them $2. Men. They feel a lot of empathy for the guy who offered them $5. But they feel zero empathy for the guy who offered them $2. Then. They ask them if they feel revenge against the bad guy. Women. They feel a little bit of revenge. Men. They feel a lot of revenge. Nucleus accumbens, it sits in the bottom of the basal ganglia, involved in reward and pleasure. Then. The subject saw how the bad player was getting shocks. And when men saw the bad player getting the shocks, their nucleus accumbens activates. So, for men, revenge equals activates the reward system in the brain. And for women didn't turn on a lot. E.g. 3. Terry Schiavo, 1990. She had a cardiac arrest, went into a coma, and then vegetative state, they're awake, their eyes are open, but they're not aware of anything. They put her a feeding tube. Then, 8 years later his husband asked to remove his feeding tube. But his parents didn't want to. There were several U.S. Supreme Court decisions about whether to remove the tube or not. Even President Bush signed a bill to keep her alive. But she was disconnected in 2005. Another woman. 2005, 23-year-old woman. She emerged from a coma, had no awareness, but preserved sleep-wake cycles. Then. Some people did mental imagery tests on her in a fMRI. They read her some instructions. To imagine that she was playing tennis. And to imagine her visiting all rooms of her house. As you know, we can see imagination in the human brain. In both cases. The supplementary motor area, plans your physical movements. And the parahippocampal cortex, parietal cortex, and parahippocampal cortex. Both were activated. But. They tried this with other vegetative patients, but it didn't turn on these areas. So it seems that only this patient had these parts of the brain functional.